Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Kindly rise for the national anthem. Balaji Society. It also gives us immense pleasure and honor that is I, Devang Rajgore,
and I, Parmal Kulkarni, to be the masters of the ceremony. Our commitment to students and the systematic training imparted to them by mature trainers from the industry and faculties have helped us to stand up to the expectations of industry, leading to the most successful corporate career. We, in Sri Balaji Society, have always tried consciously to groom our postgraduate management students to strive and succeed in the industry, not only as a professional leader, but also as a responsible citizen.
Sri Balaji Society is not only known for discipline, dedication and determination, but also for very good environment, conducive atmosphere, excellent faculties and above all, corporate interface, where more than 100 corporate leaders interact with our students in a year so that the students will have a smooth sailing in the industry. Inspired by the mantras of discipline, dedication and determination, our students have proved to be an asset to industry.
We owe our healthy growth and development to the help and support of corporate leaders like you. We are fortunate to have been blessed with the Association of Corporate Leaders from different parts of the country who graciously spare their valuable time to impart training and groom our students in the form of guest lectures, workshops, management games, seminars and informal interaction.
There is a conscious effort on our part to ensure that our student managers learn directly from corporate leaders. We believe that interaction with the stalwarts from the corporate leaders like you is a must for the development of students, particularly those who are in the B schools.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Festival of Knowledge. Welcome to the 10th National Business Convention. This National Business Convention is organized by the students of Balaji Institute of International Business, BIIB, on behalf of all the institutes of Sri Balaji Society. Balaji Institute of International Business is proud of our sister institutes, that is, Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, BITM, and Balaji Institute of Management and Human Resource Development, BIMHRD, would also present here to witness this Festival of Knowledge, National Business Convention, which takes us on a journey of learning with the corporate stalwarts.
Following our tradition, we start the journey of knowledge today with the lighting of the lamp, which symbolizes the light of life. May we now request most respected, highly distinguished chief guest, Mr. Subrahmanyam Birbar, Group CEO, Sandhu Group of Companies. Guest of Honor, Chitranjan Mohanty, JP Morgan, Chase and Company. Directors and other dignitaries to light the auspicious lamp and commence the 10th National Business Convention, Challenges on the Dynamic Business Environment.
Thank you.
May we now call upon Ms. Riddhi Patel, Student Manager of Balaji Institute of International Business, to deliver the welcome address.
A genuine leader is not a searcher for consensus, but a molder of consensus. Good morning, respectful chief guests, guests of honor, dignitaries, directors, faculty members, and student managers. I, Riddhi Patel, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of International Business, feels privileged to welcome you all to the day 3 of the 10th National Business Convention on the theme Challenges in the Dynamic Business Environment 2016. We feel immensely delighted to have amidst us several distinguished leaders from the corporate world to share their success stories with us, also to divvy in their experiences regarding the challenges to be faced by the upcoming generation of the managers. I'm sure today's event is going to be a great success as the previous days and will leave an impression on all of us. So let us commence the last day of the 10th National Business Convention 2016. Thank you.
Thank you, Riddhi.
May we now call upon Dr. Suresh Chandrapadi, Director, Balaji Institute of International Business, to deliver the welcome address.
Yeah, today also I am excited. Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Subrahman Veerabar, Group CEO, Sandhu Group of Companies, Guest of Honor, Mr. Chitaranjan Mahanthi, Executive Director, JP Morgan Chase, all the directors, faculty members, and above all, the dear students, to those even those who are sitting on the aisle. It is a great day for all of us to welcome you. It is a great day for me to welcome you on the third day of 10th National Business Convention on the theme Challenges in the Dynamic Business Environment. We are really honored on this morning by the presence of our chief guest as well as guest of honor and other directors who have graciously accepted our invitation and come here to address and share their knowledge and experience with you all. Today, we will really witness the experience of, besides our chief guest and guest of honor, we will have Mr. Abhijit Bhattacharya, Chief Human Resource Officer of Tata Capital Limited, Mr. Sanjeev Parker, Senior Director, Human Resource of Pricewaterhouse, Mr. Deepak Chawla, Head HR of Reliance Infrastructure Limited, Mr. Amit Ves, Director and Head HR of Barclay Technology Center India, Mr. Chetan Tulia, CHRO of Tata Power, Mr. Arvind Ganesh, Senior Director of IDFC Bank, and Mr. Venkatesh P, CHRO of GMR Hyderabad International Airport Limited. I am really delighted to see the students of all the four institutions of Sri Balaji Society, that is Balaji Institute of Modern Management, Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, Balaji Institute of International Business, and Balaji Institute of Management and HRD are present here. Dear students, I value your participation. Let me tell you, today you will have a highly memorable, educational, and not to be missed one, the third day of 10th National Business Convention on the theme Challenges in the Dynamic Business Environment. You will definitely remember this event. Before I tell anything, I will, you know, try to tell you a context. The first day I spoke to you about the disruptive leadership or the disruptions happens in the industry and economy. Second, I spoke to you about how the changes takes place. And the third day, I will tell you nothing. I will tell you a story before I tell anything. One day a person goes to a shop to buy a parrot. He went there. The shopkeeper told him, "Sir, I have 3 parrots. So which one you would like to buy?" That person told, "I will buy the first one." He asked for the price. He said, "It is 10,000 rupees. He was surprised. He said, "10,000 rupees for a parrot? What does it mean?" "No," he said, "you should know his quality." He said, "What is the quality?" "Now the parrot can write or the type in English through his beak." He said, "No, but 10,000 is too high." Then he showed his finger to the other parrot. He said, "What is the price of this parrot?" He said, "It is 50,000 rupees. He said, "What nonsense it is." "No, no, you should know his quality, because this parrot knows also the SAP with all the modules." He said, "But I don't think 50,000 is worth for it." Then he pointed his finger to the third parrot. He said, "What is the price of this?" He said, "It is 1 lakh rupees." He said, "1 lakh rupees, why?" He said, "I don't know what he does, but people call him director." So, I am one of them. See, you are, I feel sometimes you are really, really lucky because you are born in this as a category of millennial. If you talk about 30, 40 years, the chief guest and the guest of honor who are sitting here, I am again excited because all 3 of us are from Odisha. The chief guest, guest of honor and myself standing here. Das sir is also, yes. So 30, 40 years, if you see, that time India, people were having only 3 options. Either you join the engineering, or go to, if you are an engineer, then you are lucky and get some, at least a proposal for the alliance. Or at medical you have to go, and third, defense you have to go. The defense sector was there since 1947. See, the other sectors were not there, but today India has a lot of opportunities. In those days, it was considered as a poor country, pitiable country, but today, and those who were coming to India, they were saying what they can do for India, but today they all are coming with the hope what India can do for them. So that is the changes have come, because you are the future of this great country called India. We have a voice. We are the second largest economic power of this world. We have a voice in the global scenario. We have sent. We have created many scientists, engineers, even we have sent orbit to Mars. That time somebody was calculating, even the cost of sending an orbit to the Mars is lower than the Bollywood or the Hollywood movie. So that in the first attempt, India was successful to send the orbit to Mars. So that is a great achievement. Even if you see, our Bollywood dances are also practiced in our world capitals. We are the champions in Indian cricket. Or the cricket. Even we got the rupee symbol, which was not there. And the number of billions is almost doubled in these 2-3 years. So that definitely is a great, great achievement. So who is responsible for it? It is the leaders who are responsible. I am not talking about the leaders like Lalu Prasad Yadav or Mayawati. I am talking about the leaders, those who are sitting on the dais, and the leaders who are sitting in front of me. So they are the leaders responsible for making this happen in these 30, 40 years. If you talk about the invention of internet and the technology, we have crossed all the boundaries. No physical limitation now. India is having also a huge, huge advantages that is called 3 Ds. One is the demographic dividend. Second is huge demand. and we have a vibrant and the largest democracy of the world. Now, with all these advantages, even if you see nowadays newspaper, even Baba Ramdev is also giving challenge and nightmare to all the MNCs. One person has created this kind of revolution and disruption in the country. We talk about maybe economic disruption or something happens. If you see sometime back the Kabali movie was released, there was no ticket for it. So that, see, then it shows the economy is definitely there. Economy is flourishing. Maybe 2 days back I was also seeing Akshay Kumar is also trying to act in a movie called Toilet at Prem Katha. That has come in paper. So the changes are happens. So you should definitely think India is growing and you are the real beneficiary of this country. But at the same time, you should think how do you say India is really doing, and whether everybody can do it. Everybody can take these advantages. If I see there are so many peoples like who have achieved their name in the global market. You know Indian-born Sundar Pichai is the CEO of Google. You know Satya Nadella is the CEO of Microsoft. They all are Indian-born. Indra Nui is the CEO of PepsiCo. Even Ajay Pal Singh Banga, who is from Pune, he is also the CEO of MasterCard. Before that, you may have heard of Santanu Narayan. Before that, you have heard of the Francisco D'Souza. So all are from India, and they all are the leaders of today in the global market, in the global best companies. But the same thing, you should also know, it is because they have given or they have tried to build up their strength. So all of you should understand, in this prosperity economy, you also can do wonders, provided you are willing to. I will tell you again a small story. You know the rabbit, they all were going to rabbit schools. So the rabbit was very good in hopping, but very poor in swimming. So everybody told, you forget about hopping because you are already good at it. So you should concentrate on swimming. So he thought, then he did not practice the hopping and tried to, you know, get into a tuition class of swimming. But after much effort also, he couldn't do it. At the end of the examination, he failed in both. Both in hopping as well as swimming. So that is the condition of your. 80 million millennial people are there and you are the best out of that. You are good at, that's why you have come here to this college. But instead of focusing on your strength, you all are taking the tuition class of how to follow others and how somebody will sit behind you in your motorbike and that too without helmet. So you, because you are focusing in some wrong direction, some of you are not able to, or people you fail in both as well as your studies as well as the other things. So try to concentrate on your strength, where you have come from, what is the purpose, what is the purpose of this convention. You should focus on that. Definitely your career and perspective is very, very bright. See, everybody tries to reach their dream. You also try to reach your dream as well as I. Everybody. So one day one man asked, how will I get strength to reach my dream? So he asked everybody. Then he asked his mother. He said, how can I get my strength to reach my dream? He said, see, I definitely want you to give the strength to reach your dream, but I have this much strength. Whatever I had, I have already given to you. Then he did not find the answer. He went to a holy man. He said, you do one thing, you do the prayer. You will get the strength for your to reach the dream. but he was not satisfied. Then if he try to go to Baba Ramdev or Nirmal Baba, they will say, ki, okay, do yoga. You will get the strength to reach your dream. Even if you ask Dilip Bam sir, he will say, it is law of nature to reach your dream. But finally, he couldn't get convinced. Then he asked an old man. He said, you can definitely reach your dream or get the strength to reach your dream. Have you asked yourself? Now, instead of asking yourself, you are trying to ask everybody. That is why you are not getting answer. So try to ask yourself, how will you get the strength? What will you do to reach your dream or to reach your destination? Ladies and gentlemen, I will give you, you know, this Rio Olympic, 17 years old Yusra Mardani was a refugee of Syria.
Yes.
She along with her 20 the refugees stuck in Turkey and the Greece in a dinghy, small dinghy. It was supposed to be broken down. Most of the people died because they couldn't swim. And Yusra Mardani and her sister, both of them, they swam across the river and tried to save as much as possible to all the people, those who were with them. The same Yusra Mardani became the first refugee athlete of Rio Olympics. No country, no flag, but the first athlete who joined the Rio Olympics. So when the life gives you the options of swim and sing, it is you who has to choose whether you want to swim or sing. So you all have to think, you have to swim and cross the river, then only you can succeed. You can become like one of the global leaders today India has produced. So don't think, okay, now the destiny is there, I will do, the destiny is there for me, whatever will happen because of the destiny. Because there God also writes in all the pages, as you work hard. So today, it is again a great day. The great stalwarts, the great corporate leaders are coming here to address you all. Take as much as opportunity and create your destiny. Take this opportunity and make it a memorable one. Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
It's a great honor for us to have such renowned corporate stalwarts amidst us today. We are very grateful to our Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Shubrar Bindu Birbar, Group CEO, Sandhu Group of Companies, and Guest of Honor, Mr. Chittaranjan Mohanty, Executive Director, JP Morgan Chase & Company, for having accepted our invitation. May I now call upon Dr. Suresh Chandrapadi, Director, DIIB, to welcome our Chief Guest with a bouquet. Professor D.S. Kadam, Director, Projects and Alumni Affairs, to welcome our guest of honor with a bouquet. Thank you, sir.
May we now call upon Ms. Rupa Gupta, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of International Business, to introduce our Chief Guest.
Thank you, Devon. A very pleasant good morning to one and all present here. I, Rupa Gupta, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of International Business, feel highly privileged in introducing our Chief Guest, Mr. Shubhra Bindu Birbar, Group Chief Executive Officer at Sandhu Group Limited. Sir is a highly qualified person. After his graduation, he has done post-graduation diploma in advertising, marketing and system management, as well as post-graduation diploma in logistics from IIM Ahmedabad. Sir has worked with different companies like Gammon Infrastructure Project Limited, International Seaport Private Limited, AEE Rand Baxi Limited, Visa Group London. Sir is currently working with Sandhu Group Limited. Sir is member of five 5-member core committee on port infrastructure of CII West India, member of 5-member core committee on logistics of CII West India, sir, has played a lead role in establishing imported core trade in southern and western India. Sir, we are honored to have you here amongst us. I request you to come and enlighten us with your words of wisdom.
I was just thinking about Dr. Pari when he started with the parrot story, and immediately followed by that we three belonging to Orissa. So I was just trying to find the similarity. He said, I'm the director. The second thing what was coming to my mind, so that makes leading the CEO, most of the time people ask, what do you do as a CEO? All of your finance department does finance work, the HR department does their work, the operation does their work. But what exactly you do as a CEO? So there are a lot of similarities when you see that, you know, you come off, you try to do something, you follow your dream. The topic itself was talking about the challenges in 2016. I'm sure you as students must be finding it, the challenges, where there are challenges, there are opportunities. Had there been no challenges, any Tom, Dick and Harry would have been doing the job. You don't require management graduates to come over and take over the things. Then what do you exactly do when you start your career? When, you know, the maybe 22, 23 years ago, I was sitting on the other side of the dais, people coming and telling us about the stories, how to go off and other thing. After 22 years, when I look at life, how it has passed and how things have moved on, most of the time you find, rather than the textbook, life teaches you a lot. Every case study, when you go through it, it teaches you a lot. As Dr. Pari was telling, you follow your dream, irrespective of, and you find out what you are good at. If you look at the corporate leaders in today's world, I'm taking few of the big names in the Indian industry who have become great leaders. Okay, some of them are entrepreneurs. They may not have this privileged educational background, but you guys, we are having kind of thing. You look at Mr. L&T chairman, Mr. A.M. Nayak. He's just an engineer. He has never done his management. But look how he is managing almost a $12 billion company. When he took over, it was just 1 billion. But if you look at his life story, how he evolved, what all he did, and how to reach that stage where he took this 1.2 billion company to a $12 billion company. Only thing what was there, he just wanted to succeed. That perennial hunger in himself, how to do better. Every point of time when he was recruited in L&T, because why I'm telling you all this, because I was part of the L&T and I was reporting to Mr. Nayak directly, so I have seen the person who is now 75 years old puts in 18 to 20 hours a day. He is having a bypass surgery, he is having a pacemaker attached to his heart, highly diabetic, high blood pressure, but that doesn't deter him what he wants to do. One day I was just asking, sir, you are already 75, you are supposed to retire. They said, in your wildest dreams. I will die, but I will retire. And what is it? I said, then what's your last wish? He has taken my house somewhere in Powai, which is very close to the Powai works. He said, I want to die seeing my factory lights on. Look at the dedication of a person when he wants to achieve something. He has not taken a days off when he was working with L&T in the initial years. Most of the time, L&T is used to recruit from IITs only. And he was the only guy who was a non-IITian. And there is a constant hunger in himself to prove himself that I am better than the IITian. So look at what happened. When he started believing in himself, I can do wonders. I want to learn. I want to plan. So he didn't become complacent about things. He started looking around. So there are two things happen in that case. One is data sufficiency. When you look at data, how much data you can assimilate. As a student, all of us have done in our own role when we are growing up. Try to accumulate as much possible. I was hearing from Dr. Pani there in this international business. I was interacting with one of my friends, who was telling me he was into international business. But look at international business today. It is dependent on so many factors. Are you keeping a tab of things, what is happening in and around you? And everything is so interrelated, you can't ignore one thing happening in one part of the world is going to impact and affect your work, your planning. So we used to do the same thing. Look at it, whatever we can plan. What is your vision? Another important thing what I wanted to tell you. When you have what you want to achieve your dream, but have you ever asked yourself what your dream is? The second thing comes, how to achieve my dream. But what your dream is? Do you want to be a corporate leader? Do you want to be an entrepreneur? Do you want to play a helping hand? Do you want to be a team leader or an individual contributor? All those things comes from within. No one can tell you because you yourself know what you are and how you can achieve things. Corporate will teach you, unless you are attentive, you will miss out a lot of things, what is happening in and around you. When you have a constant eye on what is happening in and around you, then you can plan your success. But how to succeed? Suppose you find yourself a very good individual player, a great team player, but you are not a very sociable person, there's nothing wrong with it. Because that's your dream, you want to achieve something. Like Dr. Pani was trying to tell, if you know the rabbit tries to do the swimming, don't try to do something which you are not good at. And that you yourself know. Forget about the criticism of what people are telling, what people think about it. You look at all the leaders throughout, all of them have rose against criticism. Because complacency, good words always makes you very complacent about things. Okay, I'm good at that. But when you don't have, then you strive for it. Then you want to prove yourself. That's where a lot of inner energy comes in. So that's how, in the corporate world, the same way when we'll be moving up, we'll be finding new challenges coming up. When the challenges come up, then there are two ways. Once you plan the things, are you following your plan with concrete steps? How you are going ahead, how you are doing things. And then, where you want to achieve, are you keeping a tab of your milestone? Have I achieved something? Every day is passing by. Am I a better person than what I was yesterday? What will my tomorrow will be better than what I am today? So there are the few things once we have in mind. We do things, a lot of things, the frustration and other things will creep in. Now we are in a very secluded environment of the educational institution where you have the books, you have all the good professors who are teaching you, that making you feel safe. Out in the corporate world, that becomes a rat race. But again, ask yourself, do you want to be in the rat race? Because irrespective you lose your name in the rat race, you'll always remain a rat. So don't be a rat. You are a human being. You plan your thing. You plan your success, don't compare yourself with others. In the corporate world, there will be a lot of new things which will be coming up, which are challenging, which has never been taught. But if you are attentive, you would have seen it during your friendship, how you are interacting with your colleague or with your friend. That's how you will be doing with the team with which you will be working in the initial stages. Are you attentive towards the needs of the team members? Are you attentive to whatever is happening in and around? How people will accept you as a natural leader? People will accept once they find out, okay, he understands where he wants to go. He understands, then the people will start following you. If you want to be a leader, to lead the entire scheme of things. But for being a leader, you need to learn a lot. During this phase, when you are a student, when you will be getting into the corporate world, that point of time, a lot of challenging things will come up, how you are going to address those areas. Few of the things I'll try and share with you.
when one of the interviews we are taking, one of the guys who are coming to at least the interview in the L&T, so Mr. Knight, for his executive assistant post. So he was an engineer from some college which is closer to Orissa somewhere. So Mr. Knight, as usual in his self, he was just asking, why should I recruit you? I need an executive assistant. It's an executive assistant to the chairman of L&T. And you are not coming from a very reputed institute. You know, the sharp answer from the student was, I don't think you have also come from a very reputed educational institution. But I have faith in myself that I'll prove I will become. And that guy rose to the rank and file. That guy was heading the entire airport sector of L&T within 5 years. This shows when you are very confident about yourself, you become very fearless. You don't hesitate to express yourself. Once you can express yourself, that shows that you have got a lot of inner confidence. When you have faith, everything will fall in place. But at the same time, in the changing world, never allow your child in you die. Because that every time, a child, it keeps learning. Its mind is always open. It looks at the things in a different perspective. I'll give you another example to sort the things out, which I have heard from a lot of leaders who I came across in my career path. You know, there was a cow and a calf, and there are a lot of people who are trying to detach, just take the calf away from the mother because it's drinking milk and they wanted to just sift it. So everyone was pulling, pushing, a lot of energy was getting wasted and other things. And there was one guy whose son came in because his wife was waiting for lunch. He said, what your dad is doing, just go to office and try and find out whether he can come in, kind of thing. He just goes there and sees this struggle going up. He said, what are you doing? He said, we are just trying to move the calf from here to there. We have created all the dynamics kind of thing, which way we should tie the calf, which angulation it should be there so that the calf's face will be away from its mother's distance and it can move down. This is very simple. He said, what are you talking? He is just a class 4, class 5 guy maybe. He just goes in, puts his thumb in the calf's mouth and starts walking. And the calf moves to the other center. He said, for last 4 hours, we are thinking, this is what happens when your mind is clouded by so many preconceived notions. This has to happen in this way, as per the management principles, what we have read in our books, as per the management principles somewhere there. Not looking at the simplest principles in life, this can be sorted out. For that, you need to be in a very calm mind. When you move, there are two things what happens. When you are determined, you want to achieve something, move like a colossus. There is no ending. You are the winner. No one is going to decide for you what you want to be in your life. It is you, yourself. You don't look for a certificate from anyone, from your friends, from your relatives. Everyone will be talking something or other. But once you believe in yourself, you don't care. But at the same time, don't be disrespectful and telling them you don't care. Just smile and walk. That shows many times a confident smile and walking. It will show that's the character, that's the person you are. And you are here to win. You are not looking for certificate from people. And I don't know, this guy is not from Harvard, he's from UAE or something. So what? All these leaders. Look at Mr. Gautam Adani. I think he just completed his graduation very recently. He was in standard 11, 12. Look at Mr. Dhirubhai Ambani. They had a vision. Do you have a vision? If you have a vision, just follow it with all passion. Nothing in the world can stop you. But again, going back, half that child in you who will be looking for solution, calm down most of the time. Look for some simple solutions in life. When the mind is in a very fluid state, it will never give you a solution. It will be looking at more about the problem. A worried mind will always be walking negatively. And in negativity, you will never find a solution. But a concerned person will always look for solutions. I was just reading an article which was telling, there are some people who are lucky and some people who are unlucky. Some people are lucky to achieve things very fast in their life, they move very fast. At very young age, they start achieving. So some researcher in the United States was working on that and tried to find out what exactly is the difference between lucky and unlucky people. So they have introduced some 300 odd samples of lucky people and unlucky people. They brought them for a taste, and at the end of the taste result, there was a newspaper they had put in. Said if there are number of pictures are there, if you can count the number of pictures, then you will win the taste and you will get $20. So in between the picture, there was a small nice photograph where it was written, if you can show this photograph to the interviewer, you'll be getting $50. All the unlucky people found out, all those people who were considering themselves unlucky and who were interviewed as unlucky people, went back, they missed out the area where it was written, $50 you'll be getting looking at the picture. Whereas the lucky people, so the right place at the right time, because you have the mental ability to look at things, to decipher what's going to be right, whether it is falling in place, and they are very happier people. They feel very contented. When you are contented, it's like a reflection of water. If you disturb the water, you can never look at its face, look at your face in the water. But when there is no turbidity, it is calm, you can see in the bottom of the ocean. Even I have seen some lakes in Pangyong, I think it is in Ladakh, but you can see at the bottom of the lake, even at 10 meters down, because it's a very calm and serene atmosphere. When you are calm, then you will find solutions to everything. I'm not talking about only corporate. If I have a habit to find the solution, it must be happening now itself. Some of us get very worried. As soon as the problem comes, what I have to do, whatever. Have you ever looked at it? This is the problem. This I'm going to break it down into 3, 4, 5 pieces, which I can attach. There may be 100 miles we have to walk. There are few people who will be always doing the planning. Oh, that's 100 miles, how to walk, you know, what all I need to carry with myself, a distillery water bottle, no, there will be recurring 10 distillery water bottles. But the guy who wants to achieve something, he starts walking. With every 2 kilometer, 3 kilometer, whatever he needs, the law of nature is, you will get provided by whatever is available. In the corporate world, what will be happening? You will be reading a lot of things, how to achieve things, how to do things. The real life challenges will be different. No one will teach you that you go back, there is a beautiful project, it fits into all your scheme of things. Your SWOT analysis shows excellent result, but you go and find out there is one government authority who doesn't want this to happen. Because of some compulsion which he is having, maybe some political compulsion, then what you do? Oh, this all wrong, this country is bad, you know, nothing will happen in this country. We have to just run away from this country and find a safe shelter. Have you ever asked those guys who have run out from this country, are they in a safe shelter? Or the problems are multiple there? So whenever the problem comes, be very objective in analyzing that. If this is what the problem is, let me break it down. This is the first stage of it. I can address this. When you move from problem, the confidence level will grow. In the corporate life, the same thing will happen. You'll be challenged. Many a times you have a very good project, you have a funding problem, then what do you do? Okay, I don't have any funds. How to go ahead with that? Have you attempted whatever resources you are having? Just put into that project, then you move on. Then go to a financial institution, then go to an investor who looks at the project, oh, it looks good. So this is how the corporate world, you will be moving, you will be looking at it, then solving the problem, and with every step, finally one fine day, rather than having a big dream and thinking about it, have a dream, keep walking, make it into smaller pieces, smaller these things, okay, this 1 year, I'll achieve this one. Is there any shortcoming? There can be two things. There will be a shortcoming that I cannot achieve this in 1 year, it goes to 1.5 years kind of thing. Or if you are good enough, you are very dedicated, what you will do, you would have completed in 6 months, you would have covered the next year's 50% of it. That will make you a leader. And suddenly you will find out that you are in a much advantageous position than your competitors are. Because when your competitors were sleeping, you are walking. You kept on walking and doing things. The modern day world, the business will be a little more challenging, which will be bringing a lot of opportunities for you, which will be challenging your creative thinking. How you are going to address those those problems and how to achieve success in those kind of areas. A lot of companies, even some people who are doing in the international trading, the trading of commodities will suddenly change. So what is your backup plan? Have you ever thought, if I fail, is there a backup plan B or plan C? Something is ready, which I can rely on. Or otherwise it will land you in a very frustrating space. Because you don't have anything. Suddenly you fail, you don't know where to come back up. But there is the other way of it. Because you have got a plan B and C, you may not focus completely on plan A because you will be looking forward. When am I going to fail so that I can fall back on plan B? So it's all in your mind, all the mind game what will be happening in the corporate sector, in the corporate field. India is growing, it's going to be the second largest economy in the world. Are we prepared? Are we in the right place? And where we are envisaging our role to be in this greater world? That's where, once we define ourselves, first of all, you define yourself, your dreams, what you want to achieve, vis-a-vis where the world can fit you in. No one, I have not seen a single individual last 22 years of my corporate life, a deserving person ever been thrown out of an organization or not been recruited by an organization. Because the guy who is sitting on the other side of the table, who has seen corporate life, 25 years, 30 years, they don't look at your credentials. Trust me when I'm telling you this, when I sit in the interview board, along with my colleagues, all of us having the same idea, we look at how this person is eager to learn, how much passion he is having. He wants to do it, he wants to deliver, he wants to achieve, irrespective of whether it is sales and marketing, whether in finance, how creative it is, and how easily he gives in. It's a very simple thing. Maybe this will be helping you during your campus interview. The first thing we do, if the guy, we say that, okay, what's your expectation? He says, 10 lakh per annum is fine. Sorry, we can't provide what we are looking at. Our company policies, we take entrants at 6 lakh, 7 lakh. We can't give you more. The instant reaction of the student, the person, shows what he's going to achieve in future. If your reaction is, okay, sir, it's fine, I can. That means you give in very easily. If at the same time you say, maybe sir, thank you very much, thanks, you have interviewed me, but my this thing is, I will go for 11 lakhs, 10 lakhs. If somebody gives me fine, otherwise I'll create my own. Always, there is one, I think, letter which was written by Abraham Lincoln to his teacher. This one line which will be apt for the management graduates and the others, which will be very helpful. Said, always put a price on your brain and brawn, but never put a price on your heart. Be very compassionate, but whatever you have won, hard-earned degree, never give up so easily, because that shows your character in going ahead. Anything, you love someone, you love your job, anywhere, how easily you give in to things and how difficult and not you are. But again, he had also written in the same line, which ends, never put a price to your heart. Be charitable when it comes. If you would have seen, all of you would have seen when the badminton match is happening and the PV Sidhu lost it. The way she behaved, that shows her character, that shows a leadership quality. I lost, so what? Life is much bigger than that. Goes, picks up the racket, keeps it at the right place, picks up Narayana and hugs her. So always have the combination of, that shows a good leader. If you want to be a very rash, aggressive, you'll be a short-term leader within a few days. Corporate world is deadly enough to chew you off and throw you somewhere that you will never realize that whether you are ever in the race. But when you have, you decide yourself for yourself whether you are running a sprint or running a marathon. There are two entirely different skill sets which are required. I don't think Usain Bolt even can run a half marathon of 21 kilometers. And life, I feel it's always a marathon. And enjoy yourself every day, whatever you are doing. don't have so much of this thing on the destination that, you know, one fine day I'll be a CEO of an organization, I'll be the global CEO, or I'll be somewhere else. I don't think those people actually enjoy anything. The enjoyment is actually in the journey. Trust me, you guys will miss this college life, this camaraderie, this hostel life, the small fights, when you grow up in the corporate life. Unless you have enjoyed the journey, then you don't know. You have missed out a lot of things. One fine day you become the CEO of an organization all alone. Do you like it? I don't think so. It has always to be shared. So be a good human being, good citizen, and a compassionate citizen who puts in all his effort. And you may be, you know, every one of you must be thinking that what as an individual I can do, what difference I can make. There is one of the coastlines in the northern coast of US. Actually, I heard it from one of the global heads of Gazelle Capital when we were doing a takeover exercise. He was just telling me this story because there is a takeover from Jewelry Free Zone, which was taking over a company called Gazelle, which was the Walmart's warehousing division. So he was just telling that everyone is concerned, what can I do? This is a much massive and bigger organization. Where do I fit in? So he was just giving us this example. During a high tide and flood-like situation, a lot of these jellyfishes, they have come onto the shore. So everyone was thinking on the coastline, everyone was very worried, what will happen to these jellyfishes, all are going to die. There is a little boy sitting there. He said, we can't make any difference, what we can do? He just goes, picks up one jellyfish and throws it, bounces it back into the water. So I don't know about the rest of it, but I can make a difference to this one. Similarly, I can make a difference to the other one. That's how you look at life. You look at life, how we can make a difference. Not make a difference what society is thinking about you, what other people are looking at you or not. It's more of inner peace. More for yourself. Happier person you are, more successful person you will be. That should be always a constant smile playing on your face, despite of all difficulties. I think there was a long this thing which keeps on going that happier people are not the people who have everything in their life, but happier people are the people who knows how to live in difficult times and still with a smile on their face. Wishing all the best.
Away from the car. But what ultimately worked was the smart work of the little kid. What would you as a CEO prioritize, the technical knowledge or smart work, as companies still look for grades of the freshers and shortlist the freshers according to the grades first?
Okay, initially to do it, because the car example is apt when you are in the system itself, then you'll be looking at it. But there should be a good combination of hard and smart work, unless the people who are technically strong. Suppose, I'll give you an example, because coming from a construction industry for quite some time with L&T, unless the guy is technically sound, he may have some good solutions, but the breeze may collapse if you have a wrong design in place. So there will be a 50-50 kind of chance. So be like that, you know, all of you would have seen that photograph of the crow putting stones in that small pitcher to get the water. So now the present day crow, okay, what you can do, this is a smarter crow now. What he is doing, he is no more putting the stones in that. He tries, runs around and finds a straw. So that's the difference. Be technically sound because it will help you. But at the same time, don't get too technical about things that you lose sight about the simple solutions. So have a combination of the both the things. Be technically at least, don't try to be, it would be a wrong word, but don't try to get copper, but at the same time have the basics in place. I hope that answers your question. Thank you.
Hello sir. Sir, you gave example of a man who start walking if he have to move 100 meters, and someone start planning Is it not that if we have some vision, so we can give some time to our planning to achieve that vision?
Absolutely, yes. You should have a vision, but don't spend too much of time thinking about your vision, what you will be when you reach that spot, how it will be. Have a vision, because without a vision, because you will be directionless. Suppose you start from AIB, you don't know whether you want to go to Satara or you want to go to Mumbai. Then you go to Mumbai for some time and 10 kilometers, then you start running towards Satara. So half the vision, but don't spend too much of time. If I go to Mumbai, what would be the weather, if the roads would have been jammed, those things come in your planning. But have a fine balance between your planning and your execution, because end of the day, execution matters. A lot of things, what happens during the course of the journey, even now you must be, as management students, you must be going through a lot of case studies. There is nothing but perfect solution. You start doing something, then you iterate. Most of the things you iterate middle of the journey. After a lot of project planning, we move one end to the project, suddenly the entire environmental factor changes. What you do? Unless you start doing, you start thinking if the government policy changes, now the Donald Trump, whether he becomes the president or the Hillary Clinton becomes the president, what will be its impact, whether the Modi government is going to stay for the next 5 years or not. If you keep thinking that way, then you can never start the work. That's why I said when you get into the work, start executing it, whatever problems or whatever things come up, try to address it at that point of time. Than trying to look for solution of everything before you start the journey.
Hello, sir. Sir, suppose we have a plan A. If I want to start a company, I have a plan A. I have already had the idea that other people had this plan, he had the, means what, ways, he had other ways. Then we can learn from them. Is it always necessary to have a plan B and C?
Sorry, if you are.
So suppose I am going to start a company or something like that.
Okay.
I am going on my path. There will be difficulties, I know that. But already someone had gone through that. And we can learn from them, their experiences, their observations. Is it always necessary to have a plan B, plan C for the same path?
Of course, yes, because that guy who has started his work, if he's in his initial years, there can be two things. You can make a difference. If you are going in the same business, then you must have seen something or some difference you can make out of it. I'll give you an example of a hotel industry where all these hotels were there. Then why a Ibis has to come in, why a Ginger Hotel has to come in? Because you have got certain different ideas and in the same plane, you want to make a difference. Because otherwise if somebody is doing, like you are planning to put up a grocery shop, if somebody is doing, I don't think that will be challenging things that you will be interested in doing, because that becomes very monotonous. Unless you would like to go in the same path. And once you start, the guy who is already doing the business, with a change in the things, he will be also shifting to the plan B. If now what all these new things, you know, shopping malls and other thing coming up, do you feel all these pop and mom stores have gone away? No, they have just reoriented themselves. That is called their plan B. Not that if I fail in production of helicopters, then I straight I move into somewhere else. In the same line of business, what if something goes wrong? Because that you get an indication when I was addressing the first question from your technical knowledge. So if something is going to go wrong because you fail, you are taking a chance. Most of the time in the corporate life, you take a little bit of risk. You gamble a little bit, not much. 10% still you gamble. Okay, I'll go ahead, I'll do it. Let me see. If that fails, but you have a fallback option. Because a lot of money, your promoter's faith, everything is relying on you. That way.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning,
sir. My name is Ajay Singh and I am from Senior Operations Lab. This is a bit technical question. So suppose a part is manufactured in Noida and it takes 50 man-days and it takes 25 man-days to transfer to the care. And in between Nagpur it is exchanged between the trucks. So how this 25 days can be used and how the GST bill will help
production, you said production is at which place, the final production? Okay, so it is one of the components which is getting manufactured in Kerala and... Kerala is the ultimate destination of the product. The GST will help for the, it's more from the company's perspective. This company is basically, if it's through the pan-India basis, then they would not like, because initially, prior to GST, you used to have multiple state tax authorities. So they would not plan to have, they will have a buffer stock either created in between. It all depends on the hub and spoke model kind of thing. If you are trying and creating something, that all depends. If it is just one component and it's just coming in, it all depends, because you have to be very specific about that particular thing. If it is a high degree item which need to be airlifted, but if it is a low degree item, and you know, it can wait, because if at, as you say, at present day, it can wait for 25 days. Okay, GST can make it from the procedural point of view, 25 day can become 15 days. But if the operational point of view, you have to go through the same road and other thing, that going to remain same. There will be a difference because of the GST, two difference can happen. If the company is planning to have the locations nearby, and most of the people that try to get the advantages of the state tax benefits, that's why they, otherwise there is no point the person who is having a Noida facility and dependent on the Kerala facility finally to get delivered kind of thing. So it will, end of the day, it will all depend on the company's point of view, what they want to manufacture, where they want to sell, where they want to have the hub from where it will get supplied. Because it isn't a only plant there, this is the only simple solution of having a Noida plant and a Kerala final manufacturing unit. So once you have this entire thing, and that's why I was telling you in the beginning itself, data sufficiency is very, very important before you interpret the data.
For enlightening us with your knowledge and thoughts. The points you mentioned in your speech, like always follow your vision with passion, be objective in analyzing the problems, and do not complicate things and find simple solutions to the problems we face, have enlightened us today. They will surely help us in our corporate career. We look forward to such interactions on and off the dais.
May I now request Dr. G. Gopalakrishnan, Director, BIM HRD, to represent Momento to our Honorable Chief Guest.